We have to open it.
Never mind. Or injection.
So she has this hardening here.
Oh, we need to go cover the nipple.
Hold on. We have this high and tight caps encapsulated implant on the right and a regular implant on the left. Out as a silicone textured gel. Give him an injection. Here comes the gel coming out. This is it's called Euro silicone. Write this down. This is a non-US implant. Y179-805N-420cc's G023. So now what I'm going to do is inject the capsule. Capsule is a very, think of it like what the body does around an implant. And it happens to everyone. Everyone gets a capsule. And there's grades of capsules. One is a Baker 1, and you have Baker 2, then Baker 3, and Baker 4, increasing in severity. Capsule. doing here is getting cutting out the capsule but leaving the breast tissue behind. Those of you that don't know, I'm a huge Cowboys fan, and we won pretty convincingly last night. What do you think of that, Doc?
It's about time.
About time. Capsule looks like it's a piece of one, and it's just a hardening around the implant made of tissue, and it causes pain, and the implant can get pulled up from it. Unfortunately, we do not know how to make a capsule rate go down to zero. Working on that topic, but to make it down to zero, it's very hard. What I'm doing is cutting a little bit each section here.
Joanne wants to know, what are the signs of having this capsule?
Hardening of your implant, pain, one implant looking different than the other a bit. Good question.
Thank you.
getting through the capsulectomy portion here. Have to remove this because it's like an epithelial layer, or it's another layer that has to be removed, or else it also becomes hard. Gently removing this so that it does not distort her breast anymore. We put in a new implant. And again, you can't make it 100% that capsules are not going to happen. Capsule out right now. It's worse, in some cases it stays the same. We're just removing pieces of the capsule. We have already removed the implant.
And how soon after the implants would you know you have this capsule?
Usually somewhere around 3 months. Persistent hardening. Sometimes it can take as long as a couple years to develop. But a lot of times we'll start with medical management and stretching and massaging. And then we'll work to surgical management if that doesn't work. Medical management consists of an anti-inflammatory and the anti-asthma drug Singular. We'll try that for 90 days with massages and things. We're also getting a machine November 19th called the Aspen. And the Aspen is technology which uses ultrasound to soften the capsule while we do massages to help remove it or to help stretch it. Both an anterior and a posterior capsulectomy. Get it right off of the muscle. On the bottom side and on the top. It envelops the capsule. So now I've made it completely soft. I've removed the whole capsule. We're going to stuff it with iodine gauze, stop some bleeding, change gloves, put a new implant in and close up. Again, we don't know how capsules form. We have theories. One, two, inherent bacteria from the nipple. Three. I see capsules as late as 2 to 3 years after surgery for just absolutely no reason. We often warn patients not to get into anything that they're going to do after surgery that increases bacteria in the blood, like getting their teeth, new sets of teeth, or drillings, or fillings, or root canals, or anything that they're going to manipulate their teeth or gums, because it can spill bacteria and attach to one side of the implant. Capsules can appear for no reason. So we're all at a little bit of a loss on how to make these completely 100% go away. Again, we are getting a machine called the Aspen. It's coming. It'll be the only machine south of Dallas. With that, it helps over 10 treatments. One. Two. Three. Over 10 treatments, it promises to soften the capsule, and with massage and techniques we use that will help to push the implant down after the massage. okay, and then I change gloves. Show you a capsule in a minute on the back table. Now we're going to just inject the muscle for pain, post-operative pain reduction. A gel implant, so we will not be putting in a port. These are called Mentor Extras. Soft gel implants. She had gel implants before. She wanted to continue on with gel implants. Okay, we're going to change gloves. We'll set her up so you guys can take a look. Left of the capsule, which we're going to remove right now. Okay. Implant's going in now. I've changed my gloves. Betadine on the area. A dip deeper, please. This should feel a lot softer to her. The gel implant going in. Make her feel a lot better. Now you see the curve is back to where it is. That was the original curve. We made a nice new curve. Okay, we'll sit her up, Doc. Sir. Come back here, Amanda. Show you a pre-op picture here later. As you can see, we've recreated her breast top again. This was much higher. This was way up here before. Now we're back to normal in her breasts. Take a picture now. Good. Good stuff. Okay, good. Now we've made it a soft implant. Okay, we're good. All right, Doc. Table up. good. Now we're going to close up in three layers. If you have any questions, you can text BOOBS to 38470. Guys, we're all done. Thank you for watching. We'll show the pre and post-op for you. Removal replacement, brand new implant on the right, removal of the capsule. See you soon.